So welcome, everybody. And it's a big time difference because here it's 5 o'clock in the afternoon. And with Nico, it's 7 or 8.
Yeah, I think it's 7 o'clock. I'm not sure. No, it's actually 8 o'clock now.
8 o'clock. It feels like
8 7. O'clock from Victoria, BC, Canada.
Ah, Canada. Okay.
So, well, let's do a round of wishes. What do you wish today, Wendy?
Oh, I have to start. Okay.
Ladies first.
Yeah. Good excuse. What I wish.
If you don't want to, you need some thinking time. I can start with Koen. He's prepared.
Yeah, let's do that.
Yeah? Okay, cool.
I feel that a lot of things are getting on my nerves. And I would need some protection, I think.
Okay, what's getting on your nerves and how does it get on your nerves?
Yeah, a few things, but of course, what we all have to deal with is the situation. With the corona, I hear nothing else anymore. And people who are sick and vaccine, no vaccine, and it starts to look like that I cannot have my belongings anymore or have my freedom anymore if I don't get a vaccine. And that's starting to get on my nerves, also for my children, of course.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's bothering me and a little bit something in the relationship as well. Yeah.
Okay.
But that's a bit private.
Okay. So you, things are getting into your system and you let them get, or they are able to get into your system. And you want to be more protected on that? Is that what you ask?
Yeah. Yeah.
Let me make some notes. Okay. Clear. Thank you. Wendy, are you ready already?
For me it's the same on the moment. I experienced some panic attacks again. I don't know if it are panic attacks, but it's a really strange feeling in my body. I just never had it before. I had it like a few months ago, but now it starts again.
How did they show you what's going on? How does it appear?
How it feels. Yeah, well, it starts with some kind of tension in my stomach, in my belly. And then it's getting like building up, like a pressure that's building up. And then sometimes it's even getting up at my spine to my head. And then it's like up. And then I just don't know where it's going. And then goes out of my head and then it's gone and then it starts again, like when you're having a baby with the
contraction. Yeah.
It's okay. Coming and going, and it just don't feel nice.
And what is your opinion where it comes from?
Yeah, it's something I can't control, so that's hard for me. I the only thing I can do is just give over, or how you say that? Yeah.
Okay.
And I learned that a lot in the past, so I can do that. But my head is like getting scared, like, oh, what's happening? And I have the same what Koen has, that I noticed that the last week I was just totally in the vibe and doing my things, and then suddenly it came in my system, all the things from outside, the scaredness, the things what is going to happen, if yeah, and as a mother, what's happening with my child, and mm-hmm. how long I can protect her, that kind of stuff.
Yeah. Okay. Interesting topics, really, really. Nico, what's your wish list?
My wish list? Well, as you know, but I don't know if anybody else knows, which I will share, I just moved to Victoria, BC from Toronto. And I moved here because I needed a big change in my life. I felt that there is something that was pulling me over here. And so I've been here for about a month and a bit. I finally have a place to live, which is amazing, which I can work out of as well too. I'm very, I do similar things to Robert. Like I'm also a healer. I have my own modalities of doing this. So right now, my wish list is just to incorporate myself the best I can within the frequency of being somewhere new, you know? I go to the store and I'm still using my GPS, you know, to, you know, figure out where to go, new places and everything like that. I haven't really met any people yet, you know, just a few people here and there, right? So I'm actually putting my roots into a new place, right? And with a lot of putting your new roots, there's insecurities that come up once in a while. There's, you know, difficulties of not knowing, and, you know, I'm 51 years old, which doesn't mean anything, but it's just like I've lived in a place for so long, feeling the idea of feeling secure. But really, what is security, right? So it's the aspect of just incorporating myself in my new home and in my new place, and, you know, getting back to really the frequency of what I do, so I can help myself and others as well too, right? Because before we can help others, we have to help ourselves, right? So I want to be true to me, and I want to be true to anybody that comes and lies down on my healing bed as well too, right? So yeah, so I don't know. You can find a few little wish lists in there.
Yeah. That's a big one. No, it's a beautiful description. Okay. Let me start with saying that it's my belief system that we are all pure light. And this purity of light is embedded in the photon of the source in your heart. And that's a particle. It's a real effectual part of the source inside of you. So everything around you is built around this source part. So in fact, you are the source. You are with that, the creator of all universes. And again and again, I explain that what we feel in our inner world is expressed in our outer world. So let's connect that really, really tightly to the source. And that's connected to the central sun. It's connected to your higher self, all your helpers in the team of your higher self. And they can reach out to any other helpers. Connect it to your own heart, your physical heart. Connect that to the planet we're living on. And then we can start feeling and trusting and trusting and trusting and believing that everything what we sense around us, as long as we don't attach to it, we don't grab to it and hold on to it, it's all crap. It's all bullshit. This is only on this planet. There's nothing which we have to hold on to. And at this moment in time, there's so much information trying to get you out of your balance, getting out of your energy. And the only thing I can tell you, and I will work on it with light codes as well. And the only thing I can tell you is keep trusting, keep holding on to that source part you have inside of you. Every time when fear is getting into you, feel your heart, feel the photon of the source in your heart, make a connection with your higher self, and you can feel that this fear is easily gliding off your shoulders. And it's recognizable. There's nothing weird, stupid, or wrong on it when you feel it. But you can always go back to your heart, go back to the source, go back to all this connection I'm talking of, because that's you. So what I will do is help you to establish, reestablish, and help you remember this connection which is already there. Next to that, it's very important to start feeling that you are authentic. And being authentic means that you have to decide for everything for yourself. Making that possible for you is to start feeling what is really you. So nobody, not me, not any guru or nobody else is going to tell you what to do. The only thing you can do is feel for yourself what's resonating in the right way for you, and then work with that. And time after time after time, the environment on this planet is trying to seduce you or distract you, which is the energy of this planet. So we decided to come here and have our experiences here. And of course, there's seduction and distraction all the time, almost every second. And the only thing what we have to do with that is recognize what's happening and go back inside. Being authentic in that and try to be as pure of light as possible. That sounds all really easy, but it needs a little practice. And at the same time, you're getting better by practicing, the outer world is getting better in firing distractions, seductions at you. And seductions and distractions could also be like Nico being in a new place, because this is also a period of letting go of everything. All these materialized things we are getting used to, house, cars, whatever, computers, everything. We have to get rid of the feeling that we are attached to that, because we have to de-attach and let go all these things. And that's at the same time, it's a parallel event which is going on as well. So getting out of the system and getting detached of things. But all is based on belief. So I can tell you how things are. And you have to feel if it resonates with you, if this is your truth as well. And feel if you are a true believer in your own truth. And if you are a true believer in your own truth, then it's being completely open to it. It's like manifestation. It's like if you manifest something, you just feel, sense everything. You can taste it. You can smell it. You can almost touch it. You're already living it. And then you let it go. And then it will come. And this is like the trust is like really feel, resonate, start feeling, smelling, touching everything which can be done by your senses. And then just let it go. Don't expect anything of it, because it's already there. Because everything as part of the source is already there for you. So close your eyes, put your hand on your heart if you hadn't done that already. And just start. So close your eyes and just start listening to all these codes which are already started a few 10 minutes ago. So what I'm first going to do is connect your heart, your physical heart rooms, to the photon of the source in your heart. In these four rooms, the physical rooms, they can be connected to each other. And there's also a space, an upper space, a lower space, and a back space in the heart area. We're going to connect it also to the photon of the source in your heart. It's not need to set that. This is a quantum field, so everything is done in all time, space, dimensions, and infinities. We're going to connect the four the three spaces with the four rooms. We're also going to connect every cell in your physical body to the fountain of the source in your heart. Shur am aisha tadanata ikutus uyo ayatanana yan chukushkuyum ashashum nimcham chayin yamayana. And we also kind of connect every system, like your meridians, your blood system, your muscle systems, and also all these systems we don't even know, to the fountain of the source in your heart. To shuro to ama ai. Shundurum a katarandadatash kukushturum oishuyum ayanya. You're going to also connect all the fields around you, like your energetical field, your cosmical field, all these fields we know, and even the ones we don't know. Toshamana maisha, all to the photon of the source in your heart. Toshtanum ayantiko tosh ayamayam maishkoyan yoktaya. And we're going to connect everything together. So connect all these fields to each other, connect the fields to the physical parts to the fields, everything, and to the fountain of the source in your heart, to Shosha Iya. Riam akatu koyo no koi o storo o shumma enyananai mrondai kukoyash. So everything now around you is connected to the fountain of the source in your heart. And then we're going to connect you to the higher self and all its helpers. To the fountain of the source in your heart. Tosh ai ni mo kor do onya ni 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 uva ni 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 gana na iya shu adana na iya. We also gonna invite the helpers and the higher self to better communicate, clearer communicate, and communicate in a better understandable way with us. Tosh amani nya nya ch uro mai shu adana sha shu kuku toron toron kuku. And we're going to connect you to the central sun, and that's to the photon of the source in your heart. Connect you to the source. Connect you to the kernel of Mother Earth, Gaia. Let these connections all be a bit more stronger. Remember all the connections. And what I'm first going to do is, in the film Avatar, you can see these beautiful blue beings having some kind of a slurve in their neck, and they can connect to the tree of life. And we're going to do that with the tree of life of every planet in every galaxy. Shum ara ishana. So this is a connection activation of this ability you have to connect to every living plant, flower of the tree of life on every galaxy planet. Because this will help you to remember. And it's all done in the connection with your photon of the source in your heart. Now this is done, and everything is connected. We're going to call up all your inner childs of every time, space, dimension, infinity, and also the inner child of today. And all these inner childs which are appearing now form a circle around you. And in respect and gratitude for these inner childs appearing, we're going to connect them to the photon of the source of your heart and to the photon of the source of every individual inner child's heart. So all these inner childs are now connected to the photon of the source. These inner childs have been here for doing experiences, and these experiences were accompanied with emotions. And the emotions can be let go. It's not needed to hold on to them. So we're going to set a clearing device in place, activate this, getting rid of all not necessary emotions, getting rid of all old emotions accompanied with experiences. Ask beings to help us clear this. To kut oinya a i nukutut om asht o osht 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 om shushushushushuyanyama ayanya. And these beings will continuously go on clearing in the inner childs to ush ush ananyanch. Sur anya suk anyo toto sur anayum anayaya. So you will let go everything from your back of the neck, shoulders, back. It's not needed anymore. And now we're gonna, this is a general clearing, and now we're gonna clear specifically. And we ask those inner childs to move forward. And where we learned that we didn't trust in our system, we didn't trust the being we are. We didn't trust anymore the connection with the source and all these experiences and all these emotions evolved. We just clear these emotions now. These emotions were accompanied with programs and patterns of fear. So we're going to remove them, really delete them, reset them. So let go of these old fear programs. All these programs of fears, implants of fears, are going to take away now. Oh, in all time, space, dimensions, infinities. And this, getting rid of the fear, we create a lot of space. The space we're going to fill up with direct light and love from the source. So it's like a 360 degree shower, which I place you all in. And light and love and rays of gold will come to you now into your heart, into the photon of the source in your heart, and of that of your inner child. Okay. And this will help you to feel whatever is needed for you to be authentic and pure. But then you go so what I'm gonna do is put some remembrance and renewance in the programs of trust, belief, and letting go. So whenever doubt or disbelief or distrust appears, it will be replaced immediately by the direct love of the source. All physical signals will be detected, and will be the reaction will be filling of love from the source. Of course, we have to remember that this is by choice. We can find and look for the different information sources. So let's make choices for ourselves, which are the best information sources. And sometimes let's take away the television and the news media, things like that. We don't need the outer world getting into our system by our choice. If it's getting into our system, we can move it out, but we don't invite it in. Dus ai injakat. Shukot un ayamak. Ayor un aish. Su aya. Su uho. So this programs which were planted in our systems for lurching for more information, outer world news, you're just going to disconnect, reset. Open the throat Sakra, even more open to express more what's happening in your system. All connected to the source, all connected to the light, all connected to the heart. Chum ash in jana anash. Beings helping for the greatest good. Chum gara ta 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 shikayanya. So, how is everybody doing? Nico?
For me, it was wonderful receiving it because I was actually going into your codes itself and reading its language of its frequency, and I could see the attachment and how it actually mechanically all tied in with each other. So, for example, if you say this is a white cup and this is your white cup, I can look at the white cup and I can see the shape of it. I can see what it's made of. I can see the color. I could see its form. I can read different things in it. So that's exactly kind of what I was doing with the information. I was opening it up. I was actually looking at it different levels, and I was understanding even more why you were actually sharing these codes with us. And I could see what these codes were actually doing for me, myself, and what it was doing for Cone and Wendy and everybody else. I could actually see how it was actually almost like reprogramming, or giving, not so much reprogramming, but actually giving awareness more to Kuhn and Wendy. Is it Kuhn? I'm not reading it.
Kuhn,
right,
yeah.
So. Kuhn? Yes, I don't want to say your name wrong. To Kuhn and Wendy. And I could see exactly how it was actually serving each and every one of us. So very, very powerful what we received this morning. You know, for some of us more consciously than others, but very, very powerful. That connection that I was asking for, to actually be able to actually have more of the inner aspect of connecting to me so I could be there also for others with the work I do. I could see how you were bringing me back to anchoring, anchor over here. And I could see how you could do it. You were doing it with Kuhn and Wendy as well too. So for me, it was very beautiful. It was a blessing this morning to have a beautiful soul like you, Robert, sharing this beautiful, beautiful awakening energy with the three of us. I think the three of us are very blessed to have you and the collective that you work with and this. So yeah, very, very positive.
Is there anything still lacking or needed?
No. Right now what's happening is you've actually poured the water in the coffee, and the coffee and the water are now brewing together, mixing together, so I can have my next sip.
Beautiful. Good. Okay, thank you. Wendy.
Yeah, in the beginning I saw a flashlight, but that's, I opened my eyes suddenly because I thought, oh, what's happening? Is there thunder or is it on the screen? But okay, I thought, just go back, close my eyes. And I experienced some pain in my heart area. And then, you started to do something with the light language, and I got some the goosebump feelings in my body. And then I saw a little light in my body going, doing stuff. And then on the end, there was a grow. It was really strange, but I saw a lavender plant growing out of my third eye. Really, okay. It was sticking out. I don't know about it. Yeah.
I'm not sure what lavender means, but I think it's clearing, cleaning. It's a cleaning energy.
Yeah, maybe I had to drink some lavender tea or something like that. I don't know.
Do whatever feels right for you. Is there anything missing or lacking what you still want to have or what you didn't thought of before? Because there's much time for a second round. So.
No, it's more that I also lost myself again in thoughts. And then I was, oh no, go back. And then my thoughts were coming and, oh no, go back. So I'm slipping out a lot.
Okay. That's a control part in you, which is not needed to be giving attention. It's like meditation. When I start meditating, immediately my mind explodes. All kinds of thoughts are going around because I'm not really liking the silence. So if you just understand that they're just thoughts, it's okay. And the light language is almost like, it's like a reel of a film, which is put around you, all these remembrance experiences picked up, being put in a different light and put back. So you don't have to really take attention or make a thing of it.
Yeah.
Just let it go and trust that this is really, really get into your deepest core to assist you to be the brightest light you can be.
Yeah, I did that. Yeah, it was also that I said that to myself, like, okay, doesn't matter, it's still working.
Yeah, exactly.
Don't worry about it.
Yeah, don't worry, just trust, connect with your heart even deeper. That's what we learned last week from Koen, when there are many thoughts getting up and Koen is like easily distracted then, or putting his attention to these thoughts. And he came up with the idea or the experience that when he was more connected to the hand on his heart, feeling it tighter, then the thoughts were less had less power over him. So that was what we learned from Koen, which was beautiful. So maybe you can try to do that as well. Get even more into your hand connection.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
How is your stomach at the moment?
My stomach. Yeah. It's quite quiet, actually.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, it's more now up here on the back.
Yeah.
It's getting higher.
Getting higher to get out.
Yeah, maybe. I think so, yeah.
Okay, beautiful. Koen.
Yeah, it was really sad. Really sad.
Mm. About what?
Yeah, few things. Yeah, like I'm losing a very important match or something.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, just sad feelings, and a little light language came, and it was very like a little child. That's very sad.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so I start to cry. Yeah, at the end there was more powerful light language, which felt stronger. And oh yeah, also I have, like you, Wendy, thoughts, distraction a lot. So I'm going to press my hand harder to my chest when we start again. I know that can help a lot. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's do it second round and put up the volume a little bit. So everybody sit down, put your hand on your heart, close your eyes, please. And the closing of the eyes is not that you can't see me or not allowed to see me, but it's just that it's easier to get into your inner world. So please do that. And I'm just going to reconnect all the connections we already made in a quick fix. So all the connections with the higher self, with the source, with the central sun, with the mother earth, with all the planets around us, the trees of life of every planet, tree and every galaxy we connected to, all these inner childs, Tushukaramaya, in all time, space, dimensions, and infinities, we connect, reconnect, and restart. And I want to talk about purity of light. When we are connected to our heart, we are getting into the purity of light. And that's the only thing that's mattering. So get back to this. The awakening is getting back to the pureness in your own heart, the connection with the source. And that brings you in a trust field, the trust field where everything is okay. All is perfectly orchestrated. All is well. All is super well. There's no lack. It's only disbelief systems which we are putting in our system. So we're going to let go of all these emotions, sadness, feelings, distractions, seductions. And we're going to replace this, all this new space, gain space with pure light. So let it flow into your systems. And it's it's helping you to understand that what all we need to do is to just to let go. Let go of control, let go of all. And it helps if you have any physical problems, they're just signaling how to help you. Kushija Ataishiya. And manifestation is the next thing I want to do with you. So I want you to really start thinking of something which is on your wish list. For instance, for Nico, it's having contacts, clients, things like that, setting up his business over in this Victoria place. So what you can do is visualize in your inner world, in connection with your photo of the source, and see those customers waiting in the corridor, making appointments in your diary, feel them on your healing table, seeing coming in and out of your place, making appointments. All these things is happening when you are concentrating, feeling it. It's already there. There are many, many people needed on your help facilities. So start feeling it, start sensing it, start hearing it, start smelling it, start tasting it, start being it, start believing it. Start trusting it and then let go. Shh. For Koen, it's the same manifestation in a different angle. Start believing that you are an authentic person, that you can do everything alone, that you are not in need of anybody. And start being that person, start believing, standing and really feeling that from your inner world, trusting that everything is okay, everything is perfect. The only thing you have to do is make decisions which are right for you. And then you let everything go. Just trust. For Wendy, it's the same. Setting up your own business, setting everything around you up, the world around you is changing always. So the only thing you have to do is stand still and don't put attention in it. And trust that you are capable of doing everything. You don't need to control it. It's just there. Start feeling it, start believing it, start trusting it, start smelling, tasting, understanding, being it. And then you just let go. So for everybody watching this, manifestation is just feeling, trusting, connecting to the heart, connecting to all connections. And then feel, understand, believe, set it, and let go. You willing to say something, Nico?
Yeah, and you're hitting the nail right on the head. It's about actually, for the aspect of manifestation, I agree with you. It's about feeling it, releasing it, letting go, and trusting. Trusting you will have oxygen for your next breath. Trusting that your heart will still beat tomorrow. Trusting that your family will be okay. Trusting, letting it go. Trusting, letting it go. Anchoring. And that's what you're reminding me again. And I teach this as well. And it's like, oh, wow, I needed to hear this again. Yeah. Anchor, let go. Anchor, let go, trust. I want to actually, I don't want to take away from this, but I feel that I have a quick message for Koen and Wendy.
That's perfect.
Is that okay if I may share? I wanted to share with both of you that, and even for myself, I'm telling myself this, all right? Because I am built like you guys are, and we are all built from the aspect of receiving all the time. And living in a world that is so uncertain with so many things, and you know, there's so many pushes against this side and so many pushes against this other side, and you're like skating through life. We're all skating through life through the aspect of, where's that middle point? Where do we feel where we can actually do things for others but still be original to the self? Because at the end of the day, you got to look at yourself in the mirror. And you got to say, you know what, I'm okay with the decisions that I've made. I'm okay with the aspects of how I've actually skated and actually moved through this energy of life. I wanted to send you both a message. And the message is that not all your thoughts are your thoughts. And I do mean that. Not all thoughts are yours, okay? We live in a world called energy. And energy is all around us. If you could actually look through the atoms of everything, everything would look like, wow, what's going on in this room right now? There's so much going on, but we don't. We just see us, we see space and whatever our visual vibration can actually catch from the aspect of seeing. And what I want to tell you is that there's a lot more to what's going on that you cannot see, but you can feel. And those feelings sometimes come in with positive energy and negative energy. And they're pulls. And they're pulling us at all sides. But what we think is that is our thought, our belief system, these feelings that are ours are not yours. What they're programs that have been put into you so you can actually feed that energy, either if it's positive or if it's negative. Whatever you want to call it. So what I'm trying to tell all of you, including myself, first and foremost, myself, is what are we feeding? Okay. And if the thought isn't very empowering for me, for who I am as a person, is it really my original thought? So my responsibility is to take self-responsibility for how I feel at all times. My responsibility is to take self-responsibility for how I feel at all times, because that's one thing I can own, my feelings. That's something that nobody can take from me. It's me thinking and feeling my feelings. So don't get up too caught up on, okay, so I'm feeling this way because this is how I'm feeling. Well, maybe not, you're not feeling that way. Maybe there's an energy that has come in and is actually giving you a little bit fuel for that fire so you can feed it. Okay, so for you to anchor to you, okay, and what you like looking back within the mirror itself is to remind you through moments throughout your day, and is this the best version of Nico? Is this where I want to spend my energy? Am I serving myself or am I serving my family? So I just wanted to share that. I hope you guys can use whatever you want to use from that. All right. It was coming through like it, I felt that I needed to share this with you guys, because if we're first was actually coming for myself. You know, when I heal a client, when I'm working with a client, I'm really first actually connecting to the self. I'm rebalancing myself before my client sits, lies down on my healing bed itself. Nico has got to make sure that if he's off, he needs to put himself recalibrated. Nico's got to make sure that if he's having a weird thoughts or whatever it is, he needs to know that he's a pure vessel, that he can be ready to actually bring light or whatever he does within the frequency of assisting somebody else. So my responsibility is first to myself and then to others. That's where the best version of myself comes through. So take it as you wish. I wanted to share this with both of you, or the three of you guys.
Four. The four, yourself.
And the four of us, yeah.
Thank you. Thank you, Nico.
You're welcome.
Mindy.
Thank you. Oh yeah, yeah. I think that's for me. It's also remembering that what I try, or not what I try, what I do with my business is offering relaxation and connection. And I just lost myself. And was not connected anymore and didn't felt relaxed. So yeah, how can you give that to others if you don't feel that way yourself? So I had this streaming of new clients and suddenly it stopped and I was like, what's happening? But now, yeah, I remember what happened, because I was just getting this poison into my system. Mm-hmm.
Which is normal.
It's normal, and it's, and that is also what I said to myself, like, come on, you know, it's not very strange in what's going on. And yeah, sometimes you also can go through that and just feel it and be with it and just picking yourself up again. And yeah, now I'm starting to get in the flow of my business again, and I can do that. Yeah, it's all part of being human. And
It's like an emotion. An emotion comes to you, gets to you, gets into you, and then you have to let it go out of you.
Yeah.
So this information can be seen as emotions, and just, it's okay if it really gets into your system, and then just understand that it's there and just let it go out of your system again. So yeah, yeah. Beautiful. Koen.
There was a little bit more, there were a little bit more butterflies already. I start seeing butterflies when I get more connected. But there's still a lot of thoughts, a lot of distraction and sadness. But I think that's only good that that comes out, because that means it's inside. So if we didn't do this, then it wouldn't probably be so obvious. So I think that's only good.
Okay, super.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, I want to do a last thing. And because of all the information you are giving, the four of you, the three of you, is for me, it's getting into the part of the anchoring of the pillar of power. So that's the connection with your higher self and everything else, the trust, but anchoring this into a pillar direct from the source to the central sun, to the higher self, into you, connected to the source, to the planet Earth. So close your eyes and just receive this activation of your pillar of power. And it's done straight from the heart. And I was just looking outside of a beautiful moon, full moon. So I'm feeling that connection as well, and it helps to do that, and helps this will help you to recalibrate, to let go, to trust, to self-love, to remember, and to be aware of your own choices. And it's done in all time, space, dimensions, and infinities. And Torsh in Baka, Shurund at Yukotosh Tumrund Anyaninda, Shurshita Inya, Jan Yukotun Anya Nash, Ovodom Aya, Shurush, yeah. This is a real powerful one. That in Yakoti, so it's all connecting in the heart. Toshish Tut Anyanana. Connected to your higher self, the central sun, source, all planets around us, re-establishing your pillar of power. I could feel that this was a real powerful one. I'm sure it will support you in the coming period. The distraction and the information war is still going on, but we don't have to stand in it. We can always step aside from it and just trust that what we are doing is the right thing. Our awakening is the best thing we can do. And also remember that when you have kids, that your kids were prepared for other times as well. They were better prepared than we were. So even newborns are much better prepared for this situation than we all are. So just trust that the system is done properly. Well, really well orchestrated. Start trusting in yourself, your connection with your higher self. Start trusting. And the rest is bullshit. I can't make it any better, but it's like, and it's not easy. It's not easy. I mean, it sounds easy, but it's still, you have to do some work for it. And the trust is go back every time to your inner world, to your heart, and understand every time, and reach out if you need some help. Just reach out, because times are hard, and you it's not that you should do everything alone, or it's not bad to have some help. Just if it's hard, take that help.
I think it's also important to connect with other like-minded people, and just, you know, I think I also feel that the last time, couple of days, weeks, I feel like, oh, I'm so caught into this house with all things that happening outside, but if I don't read anything or something like that, then I realize there's not really something wrong on the moment here right now. It's all happening there. Mm-hmm. And you're getting afraid of, oh, it's getting closer and closer, and you don't want to stick your hand in the sand and just think, oh, it's all going to be okay. But yeah, it's also not nice to just keep it coming in.
you are in control of your own information system. And it's, sometimes it's good to shut up, to shut off and disconnect. Sometimes it's good to connect to people if you see a like-minded person, and then you can talk about beautiful things. You don't need to talk about the things around you, but you only have this resonating feeling already. And we have to figure out ourselves. For me, it's this is a time of letting go and to reestablish new things. Things of the old won't come back. So if I miss something of the old, I have to make it myself, create it myself, so that I got a renewed feeling of what I was looking for in the old times. So this is the dance. Nico called it skating. I call it dancing. It's the dance of energies we can do ourselves. And we are in charge of that. We can do that. We are able to just to control what's getting in and what's getting out. So I would love to thank you very much for this short hour of getting energies in the right way. I hope to see you next time. I hope that you can shine your lights on other people, because that's why we're here. So thank you very much.
Wendy? Do you also have a link for the donation?
I will send it in your messenger. Yeah. Yeah. Thank you.
And Nico, thank you also for the words. I will watch back because there were quite some things that I can use. Yeah.
Mm. Yeah. Beautiful. Thank you. Nico, can you stay for a little while? I'm gonna
stop recording.